Hello, John Talley here with Boats.net. Now, if you've been following along on our build on this 2004 Yamaha F225, you know that it is time for us to finally marry it back to the midsection. So let me go grab a cherry picker and then a chain hoist, and we'll get these two put back together. So if you're ready, let's go. She's free. Gonna pull it back, take off the engine mount, and then we'll connect it over to the chain hoist. This really isn't that tough to do. All we have to do is just lift it up a little bit more, get our gasket in place, set it down, make sure your dowels are in there, and then just bolt it back and get them torqued. So it's really not gonna be that tough. One last cleaning of the bottom of this surface because we want to make sure that it has a good seal with the midsection. Same thing for the midsection surface. Make sure it's cleaned up. Got our dowels in. Let's do this. Touchdown. Well, she is down. And what we're gonna do next is go ahead and put some red Loctite on our bolts, get those in place, and then we'll start tightening them down. All of these bolts get the same torque, the long and the short. It's gonna be 30 foot-pounds. We'll get these torqued and then remove the lift and the harness. So we've got her moved over here. Let's finish getting these other seven shorter bolts in place. And as I'd mentioned earlier, they're much more difficult to get to. The chances of me getting a torque wrench in here are almost zero. So I'll have to rely on my internal torque wrench to pull that off. I'm just gonna have to estimate that 30 foot-pounds. I think it's about right there. All right, let's get those ones on the front. Next, let's go ahead and reinstall the tube and the dipstick. Make sure that you've got your O-ring in place. Let's go and get a couple of electrical connections made. Heading over here to the voltage regulator. This is what happens when you leave something apart for a long time. I misrouted two of my wires. Rookie mistake. So I have to back up to go forward. I think we've got everything in place now, so let's get that cover back on, the muffler back on, and shoot, we'll be really close to finishing this thing up. Don't forget your intake air temperature down at the bottom. Reconnect our breather hoses one more time. All right, guys, that pretty much wraps this one up. The only thing I have left to do on the power head is just fill it back up with oil and get its covers back on. Now, to complete the outdrive, well, I need to bring the lower unit over and get it reinstalled. And then guess what? We're going to be ready to start this thing. So if you'd like to see that happen, why don't you go ahead and hit that subscribe button? That way you'll be notified when the next video drops. Listen, we just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at boats.net, and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.